went into that tournament thinking that we had a chance at winning it all.
Went to the national tournament, got to the third round, and I think we overlooked a team by the name of Vermont State.
Everything went their way. They played great, and we didn't play up to our potential. And yet, when we went to the locker room, I think everyone to the man cried deeply. And I think at that time we vowed we were coming back. What a comeback it was.
We were a very, very tight-knit group.
Like a brotherhood, fraternity.
We were like family. I mean, we still are family, really.
Talking about all 12 of us, not just the seven or eight that played, all 12 of us. And it just was that kind of a team that was destined to win a national championship.
It was just fun playing with people that were good and going on the road and basically intimidating the opponents.
We ran an offense, we call it a continuity offense. You literally could make a pass without that player being there because the offense ran so well that you knew he was going to be there even before you threw the pass.
To Kansas City. Kansas City, here I come.
When I saw our name up there, that we were seated number one, I'm like, wait a minute. We're at the top of the list of the brackets every day. It was just overwhelming to see that whole process to get there after being there 2 years before and getting knocked off.
The first game, because you get the butterflies out of you, running out of the tunnel into that auditorium. Place is packed, I think over 10,000 people were there.
Once we got to the national tournament, I mean, everybody on campus left. They were down there, including the professors.
It was crazy. I mean, our fan support was phenomenal.
You know, we were basically the home team there.
We played Linfield out of Oregon.
For the first time, I thought we were really, really close to losing.
Greg Glory hit a shot in the corner with a couple minutes left that maybe put us ahead by a couple points. And
I took a shot in the corner when before there was a three-point line. It was like 2 minutes left. The shot went in. Coach Caldwell pulled me over and said, "Son, if you had missed that shot, you would have been right here sitting next to me."
Putting it out close to the edge was the best way to put it. We almost fell in. We knew it. And so after that, we started taking care of business and doing what we had to do.
This kind of gave us some motivations to continue taking one game at a time.
Our captain, Donnie Shearing, was out one afternoon and he went by Avis rental car and he saw some buttons that said, "We try harder."
So we got some.
He said, "Hey guys, take these. Put them on your jackets." And we were wearing our leather jackets and we had We Try Harder buttons on.
As far as I was concerned, Morris Harvey was the tournament. They were a very good team. They were a mirror image of us.
That was by far the toughest game we had. This championship was very difficult. But to get there, we had to win that semifinal game, which was really a tough game.
We beat them. I said we can win the whole thing.
Darryl was given the task of guarding Al Tucker.
Coach Nolan said we're facing one of the finest players in the country. He says, but no one man can beat us, so we're going to guard him straight up. Darryl, you take him one-on-one. The rest of you guys take him straight on, but no one man can beat us. And after halftime, I believe he had 27 points. And I think Coach Caldwell and Coach Nolan got together and said, you know, we're going to change your plans. We believe one man can beat us, so we're going to double team this character. So we all double teamed him, held him to 47 points.
It's all over. The Ravens have won it, 71-65. They're the NAIA champions.
Wow! I feel good.
It was an awesome game, one that I would never forget. Al Tucker went on to go into pro just like Daryl did, but it was an awesome game, and it took a number of games, good games, for us to get to that final game against Oklahoma Baptist.
The fans stormed the court. Daryl and I actually got carried off on their shoulders.
Just to be in the center of that court and hold that banner, to say that we were champions, and it was a shot that was in Kansas City Star and all the newspapers.
The celebration was exciting. Everybody was so thrilled. The fans, the team, the city, the state.
It was probably and it still is, one of the greatest moments of my life.
I was overwhelmed with joy because I never won anything. I didn't win a championship in grade school. I didn't win a championship in high school. And I finally was on a championship team. I didn't know what it meant to be on a championship team. So it meant so much to me just to say that we were national champions.
Storybook ending. I mean, you know, you dream about it. How could you write the script any better? My gosh. Finish your senior year as a co-captain and you finish out national championship.
The whole tournament as a entity, you know, when you think back on it, you know, it's just amazing.
They could take away everything else of my life and strip it clean, but I will always be part of the national championship team at Benedictine College. You're not going to take that away from me. I can carry that all the way to San Jose.
I felt like Martin Luther King. Thank God it lasts.